हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर प्रवलिका, कंसल्टेंट न्यूरोलॉजिस्ट एट रेनोवा हॉस्पिटल, सनत नगर. दिस इज़ द माइग्रेन अवेयरनेस वीक. एज वी ऑल नो, माइग्रेन इज़ द मोस्ट कॉमन हेडेक डिसऑर्डर्स वी यूजली सी. सो इन होम दिस माइग्रेन इज कॉमनली सीन, एंड वॉट आर द कॉजेज ऑफ दिस माइग्रेन अटैक्स? सो माइग्रेन हेडेक इज कॉमनली सीन अमॉन्ग द वेमेन, एंड डज दिस हैव एनी जेनेटिक बेसिस? येस, इट डज हैव अ जेनेटिक बेसिस. 80% ऑफ द पेशेंट्स who are suffering from migraine have a first degree relative who is also suffering from migraine. And if one person in the family, if one of the parents is affected with migraine, there is 50% of the chance that the child has the chance of getting migraine. If both the parents are suffering from migraine, there is 75% of the chance that the child may suffer from migraine in future. So, and the women are most commonly affected. So what are the common triggers which cause migraine? The common triggers which we usually observe are, usually these migraine attacks are triggered by certain conditions or certain situations. Most commonly we see that is excessive stress. Stress leads to immense stress leads to a migraine attack. Apart from that, disturbed sleep or any missed meals, not taking food on right time, or excessive alcohol consumption. Some people may also have these migraine attacks when they consume certain types of foods, like foods containing monosodium glutamate, which is used commonly in the Chinese food. Apart from that, age-old cheese, which you consume, and some processed foods which contain nitrates, and also foods like chocolates. When you consume excess of these foods, that may trigger a migraine headache. Apart from these, we can also see migraine headaches when there are excessive weather changes outside. Usually winters, during winters, there is increased frequency of migraine attacks commonly observed in migraine patients. And apart from these, we also see that in females, especially hormonal fluctuations during their menstruation also leads to migraine attacks. So apart from this, we have other triggers like excessive stress, as I've already mentioned. So these are the common triggers which we see. And also the most importantly, coffee. Excessive intake of coffee or sudden withdrawal of coffee or withdrawal of coffee intake also leads to migraine attacks. These are the most common triggers which we usually see associated with the migraine. If we can identify these triggers and avoid them, migraine attacks can be controlled to a major extent. So what are the treatment options available for migraine headache? And how can we effectively prevent migraine or effectively manage migraine? So migraine headache, as I've already discussed, this is not just a headache. It is a disorder with a group of symptoms. So if we need effective management of the migraine disorder, we need to understand what is the major reason for the migraine disorder, what are the causes, and how can we effectively manage it. So when we consider the first, we consider the treatment in two categories. One is the preventive treatment, which is available, and the other is the medications, medical management. So always they say prevention is better than cure. So migraine is also a preventable disease. So how can we prevent this migraine? So mainly when we do, as for other disease lifestyle modifications, this is very important for controlling migraine. Lifestyle modifications, in the sense we have to maintain an adequate, proper, stable lifestyle. Like you need to exercise at least 150 minutes in a week. So moderate intensity exercise around 30 to 40 minutes per day, at least 5 days in a week, is essential to maintain this stable lifestyle. Apart from this, to reduce the stress levels, we can go for things like yoga or meditation, which really helps in reducing the migraine. And also maintaining healthy food habits and healthy sleep hygiene also helps in reducing the migraine attacks. Apart from this, if you maintain a migraine journal or a migraine diary, which really helps in maintaining the record of the number of the attacks and helps the patient to monitor their own symptoms, and also helps the physician to observe the attacks and also the duration of the attacks and also the causes of the attacks, so that they can monitor the symptoms and adjust the medications accordingly. So apart from this, we also need to identify the triggers which are mainly responsible for migraine, and identify the triggers and avoiding the triggers also helps in preventing this migraine. So this comes the preventive treatment.